Hello students, how are you? Today's video is not to teach you something or discuss some particular topic. Now that through giving 10 videos, we have discussed almost all the topics of the first chapter, that is electric charge and field. Now it is the time to discuss the summary. Now we'll discuss the summary of the entire chapter and in form of a memory map. We will call it memory map. And what a memory map is? The purpose of a memory map is we will frame the entire thing in such a way that it will be adjusted in one page only, let us say one A4 size sheet, and whenever we look at that one sheet, the entire chapter, what all the topics covered in the entire chapter will systematically be flashed in our memory. Fine. So how to do that? I will tell you for the electric charge and the field. This is a very important technique to learn many things, not to learn, after learning how to keep those things in the memory systematically, so that it is retained. Systematical retention is of the purpose we can recall it whenever it is required in the exam or wherever it is required. We have to keep organize everything systematically. Now we have learned, now we are organizing. And how to organize? Learn this technique very nicely so that next chapter onwards, or this also is a personal exercise. You can prepare a organized note, a memory map like this for any topic, any chapter you learn in the future. May it be for any subject, may it be for chemistry, mathematics or whatever. You develop one habit of preparing one memory map at the end of every chapter. And once you acquire that capacity and you feel free with that, you are going to enhance your own ability to learn more and more and keep more and more in your memory in a simple space, in a short space, in a less space, but so systematically that you can recall it whenever it is required. Okay, let us start with this. This is a memory map for electric charge and field. Electric charge and field. Now whatever we have learnt till now, we have learnt already. I am not going to explain any concept now, but only I am going to tell you how to put them systematically in one place. In one place means maybe in one paper. Okay, now I will do it here. While explaining it, it may consume a lot of space, and this space, how much is ever, it may not be sufficient. So I'll be showing it. Let us say this is our paper. Okay, this part is our paper and this part is our rough work. Rough work in the sense how it will look finally, very small, tiny. I will do there, it will not it may not look very distinctly to you, but distinctly is this part, and how it will look on your paper will be on this part. Now you will do electric charge and field. So basically what we have studied here. Now another point I must say that from the beginning, that it is not that you should not be very mechanical, like I have done like this means you have to do like this only. It's not like that. You just understand the technique, and after that you will apply your own brain. It may be different. It's a personal, why I am saying is, it may be different from person to person. Your memory map may be in one way, somebody else's memory map may be in other way. Just you understand the technique, how it is done, after that it's up to you. For example, you may do some diagrams, etc. Somebody may do instead of a diagram, somebody may take a very short notes, or by what you are remembering something, that figure only you may put. So what I am doing is only one of the ways of putting the things. You may put it in various ways, various creative ways. It will be your personal thing only. But I am saying one way. So just capture it so that you can do it further in your own way. So electric charge and field, basically what way we studied? Electric charge, charge related something we studied. Then electric field, field related something we studied, and electric flux. These three only we studied basically, right? Charge, when we said charge, charge related many things we studied. When we said field, field related many things we studied. When we said flux, flux related many things we studied. All the things we'll put in one paper, that's the goal of the memory map, right? Charge. In charge, what we studied, first types of charge. It can be positive, or it can be negative, or it can be zero for neutral bodies. This we studied. And another thing, important thing we studied related to charge, that is quantization of charge. Q is equal to plus or minus Ne. This also we studied, right? And when this much comes, Q is equal to plus or minus Ne, the other things, important things will come associated with that to our memory. That is why quantization is a meaningless at a macroscopic level. That question we took up, and we didn't talk much about that, right? So this much only regarding the charge. Now, regarding the field, what we have learned, see, regarding the field, when we said field strength or field intensity, we studied that. So before going into field strength or field intensity also, what is field? We studied the field can be uniform or can be non-uniform, right? Uniform or non-uniform. Now see, some of you may, instead of writing so many words, you may write only, see, I am saying it here, uniform means what? You may write only field lines when those are parallel to each other. What is uniform? What is the sign of or a symbol of a uniform field? That electric field lines are parallel to each other also and equidistant from each other also. And what is non-uniform? See, this is the memory map. However it comes to your memory, that way you have to put it. Now non-uniform, instead of writing that non-uniform line, you may write also, somebody may like that, and somebody may not require that. Only remembering this figure, that idea may come to you. And this is like this, that electric field lines will not be equidistant from each other at different points and will not be parallel to each other also. That means if you are coming towards this, your strength is increasing. If you are going away, strength is decreasing. But here, your point is here, 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 wherever it is, strength is same only. Uniform electric field, non-uniform electric field. Okay. You may write in words, Coulomb's law, or you without writing that also, you may just write it in mathematical form, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1, Q2 by R square, where Q1, Q2 is the product of the charges separated by a distance R. From there, what electric field strength came? E is equal to this much force by charge and by this much, I am sorry, this much force divided by charge. Yes, it's right. Charge. But that charge got cancelled with this charge. So Q by R square only remained. And that charge is called a test charge, right? So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. And while measuring this, so F by Q, we can say E is equal to F by Q. So when F by Q we did that Q or F by Q naught, let us say, Q's source charge, that is test charge, to separate from this Q, that's why Q naught we are taking. So limit Q naught approaching 0 F by Q naught. Remember, this much is field, so everything related to field is this much. Now rest all remain due to flux, right? Now if you look it, see, I will erase this thing to write flux because space is not there, but how it will look in one page, this is your paper, how it will look like, the title you kept electric charge in the field, then we made that, you made that three parts. What is charge? Charge, field, flux. Now charge, some points you wrote here, field, some points you wrote here, and flux you are going to write. So in flux, what things you studied first? Now just to write the flux, it will cover some space. I am erasing this field. That means field is there only. Okay, let me make it like this. Field. This field part is there only, but this details I am just erasing just to give space to the flux part. In flux, what we studied first? The Gauss law, right? What is flux?
Phi is equal to E dot S.
Okay. Then Gauss law said what?
The total flux about a closed surface is equal to the closed surface integral of E dot ds is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed in the surface.
Okay, this is the Gauss law. But after this started the main questions, applications of a Gauss law. So from here we can see applications of Gauss law. Now in applications, what and what? Remember this also. First, Coulomb's law from Gauss law. Coulomb's law from Gauss law. And there what we did? We took one sphere of radius r. O. Right, and at any point, area ds we took, and we saw the direction of the area and direction of E are in the same direction. Then we proved, we derived and we brought the Coulomb's law from Gauss law. That derivation is there, that is in your note. So those things again writing is not necessary. The purpose of the memory map I remind is only for just looking at it and getting, oh, okay, this is done, like that. You just remind the things what you have studied. The next application of Gauss law is, I am making it, giving a line here just to separate, but you should adjust in the paper in such a way that so many marks, etc. should not be there, because those marks unnecessary will create confusion again. So what is it that? Spherical cell, uniformly charged spherical cell. So in this application, what we did, we took one sphere and that is uniformly charged with some charge, we said Q, and let us say this is the center. From here, at the three points, we found any point we found the electric field here. So any point means outside also. That point may be there on the surface, that point may be there, that P inside that also the point may be there. See, now who have not watched the previous videos may be confused. So you understand this technique, or go to the previous videos, see, and come over here. I'm not explaining these concepts again in detail. I have done that already in previous video sessions. So what we did is we imagined three Gaussian surfaces considering the points. Once the point we considered outside of the sphere, once on the surface of the sphere, and once inside the sphere we took. And what are the consequences when inside we took? There our E came equal to 0, and on the surface E came E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by capital R square. And here finally outside of the sphere water came E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by small r square. And then another thing, by this application of Gauss law, we have to remember that these three we showed in a graphical format, right? In a pictorial format, right? So for that, what we took? along x-axis. Is it visible to everybody? Okay. If it's not visible, I am showing it here and I'll erase again. Now we took in a graphical, in a pictorial format, r. R is the distance of the point from the center of the charged sphere. R we took here and E we took along this direction, O. And from 0 to capital R, E was 0 only, right? Then suddenly when small r became capital R, E was maximum, which was equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by capital R square. Then it began to fall again. That is E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. If this point P is going away and away, R is increasing. Since R square is the denominator, E is falling, decreasing. R is increasing, E is decreasing. So as we go on increasing the R, first till R becomes a capital R, here at this point, R is equal to capital R. Till that point it increases, it falls. So here E was 0. See, these things I am just reminding you, but you may not write also. Just seeing that picture, you may understand, you may imagine, you may recall. Here at this point, E was maximum and E is equal to inversely proportional to square of the distance. This was the second application. Now to mention the third application, we'll erase it, but just let me continue it here. Okay, now flux. Flux we took and its use applications are there. So some points we have written flux, right? Okay, now this, and what is the third application? Remind please. I am erasing this so that we can adjust it. So again, electric field due to a long straight wire, with charge density lambda. Remember? So you are showing one wire with the uniform charge density, and then on the cylinder, not taking. Then what we did, this R we took. Then this is one surface, this is one surface, and the curved surface is one surface, let us say S3. Now the flat surfaces we took, the phi due to S1, now all the field are going perpendicular to it. So S1 is not hit by any of the field lines. So phi S1 similarly is equal to phi S2 is equal to 0. Now the total phi was for phi S3 only, and that is equal to how much? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 lambda by R, where lambda is the charge density, linear charge density of the wire, and R is the distance of the point P from the wire. This was R. Okay. So here also we had one pictorial expression of this. If we took R, that is distance of the point from the wire along x-axis, and electric field along y-axis, then when R is equal to 0, that is near the line only, it was maximum. Since R is down, it also came like this. Okay, so E is directly proportional to 1 by R, or E is inversely proportional to R. Now, what is the last application we studied for a Gauss law application? We took one infinite flat sheet of uniform charge density sigma, surface charge density, right, sigma. And because of this sheet, what is the electric field intensity at a particular point at a distance again from R, we calculated, right? And what was the conclusion of that? And this R, taking this R, we took one cylinder, remember, with the same distance this side also, we extended that. Okay, so from here to here it was R. From here to here it was N R. So what we found, phi is equal to 2 E S, that is the S of this area only. That means the area
of which how much it is being cut by the cylinder, this much area is equal to this area also, S. So phi is equal to 2s and E is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught.
Now you remember regarding this one corollary, we said that if the flat sheet is having a particular thickness,
for a flat sheet with a finite thickness, E is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon plus sigma by 2 epsilon, that is sigma by epsilon naught. So what we did, these things came to our memory now because of this thing.
So applications, in one paper when you put all these things, how it will look like? This is your paper, your title, electric charge and field is here, there, then charge, field and flux, then about charge what you read points, about field whatever you read points, and these points you remember, you need not make it a definitions, big lines, etc. Everything you make it pictorial or as easy as to just remind. The purpose of this memory map, this is called memory map. The purpose of the memory map is just at a glance, you will recap all the points what we have discussed. So regarding charge, whatever we discussed, regarding field, whatever we discussed, flux also, all the applications, four applications, whatever we have discussed, everything will be there. And everything will be on a one paper only, so that it makes it easy. Now, the utility of this or importance of this comes into picture. Now you have studied various little things only. As far as now electric charge and field, one chapter only is over. But the thing is, after this you will study potential and capacitance, current, electricity, different. So for every chapter, if one sheet is there, there will be 15 chapters altogether. 14 chapters, one chapter is now omitted from your syllabus. So 14 chapters and 14 memory maps will be there. And those 14 papers you will staple somewhere or keep it in a note, that is up to you. Now the thing is, when you do the final revision, final recap, just you will look at those things, everything are there in your memory, then you will be very confident.